Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video, I am going to discuss with you the book list for SEBI Grade A examination. So I discuss karunga ki paper 2 ke liye, to paper 2 jo hai aapka phase 1 aur phase 2 dono mein same hai. To us paper 2 ke liye aapko kaun si books refer karni hai. So this video is going to be really interesting. So let's begin. So we will discuss the books for commerce and accountancy, books for management, finance, costing, companies act and economics, okay, all the six subjects. Now this is the syllabus for commerce and accountancy. Accounting as financial information system, accounting standards, cash flow, fund flow, accounting for share capital, ESOP, buyback and preparation and presentation of company's final account. Now let us see. So first of all, to clear your basics, you have to refer to class 11th textbook of accountancy, part 1 and part 2. So you can refer to NCRT, okay, or you can refer to book by DK Goyal or TS Grewal, okay. So NCRT you can easily download, but for DK Goyal and TS Grewal you have to purchase them. Then for other topics such as issue of share capital, cash flow statement, okay, ratio analysis, for these topics you have to refer to class 12th textbook of accounts. So if you are referring to NCRT, then part 2 of class 12th book contains company's account and analysis of financial statements. So it contains topics relating to issue of share capital, financial statement analysis, fund flow statement, cash flow statement, ratio analysis, okay, all these topics you can study from there. And you can also refer to a book called Basic Financial Accounting by Professor J.R. Munga. So this is a textbook for BCom and BBA students. So you can refer to this book also. It also contains the concepts relating to basics of accounting. Okay. After that, you can refer to the study material published by ICAI, ICSI, ICMAI. So ICAI is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, ICSI is Institute of Company Secretary of India, and ICMAI is Institute of Cost and Management Accounts of India. Okay, so the study portal of ICAI is called BOS Knowledge Portal. So you can refer to the paper 1 of foundation course, which is called Principles and Practice of Accounting. So you can get the study material in the form of downloadable PDFs from these websites. Okay, then you can also refer to paper 1 of intermediate course called Accounting and paper 5 called Advanced Accounting. So these will cover your basics of accounting, all the basic concepts. Okay, then you can refer to the paper 1 of final course, which is Financial Reporting. So financial reporting contains topics like accounting standards. So it contains some accounting standards like Indian AS. Okay. Apart from that, you can refer to Ministry of Corporate Affairs website to study accounting standards. Okay. Then after that, you can refer to ICSI study material. You can go to the new syllabus and then go to study material. So there is paper 4 in the foundation program called Fundamentals of Accounting and paper 5 in executive program called Corporate and Management Accounting. So this corporate accounting contains topics relating to issue of share capital, bonus share, rights share, okay, buyback, ESOPs. Then ICMAI website, you can go to the students tab and under that you can go to courses. So paper 2 in the foundation course is regarding fundamentals of accounting and paper 5 of intermediate course is regarding financial accounting. Okay, now next is management. So the various topics in management are management, its nature, scope, management processes, the five processes, then role of manager in leadership, then task of leader, leadership styles, leadership theories, HRD, then motivation, morale and incentives, and then finally communication. So let us see from where you can study for these topics. So first of all, you can refer to class 12th BST textbook. So part one of BST textbook contains principles and functions of management. So your five basic principles, planning, organizing, directing, staffing and controlling, these five functions are easily covered in the class 12th textbook of business studies. So this will be good for your basic understanding of management. Okay, so you can refer to the NCERT book or you can refer to some other author also. Apart from that, you can refer to Principles of Management by PC Tripathi. So this is a graduation level book. This is a very good book. You can refer to this book also, or you can refer to Management Principles and Applications by CB Gupta. So refer to either of them, either PC Tripathi or CB Gupta. Okay. And apart from that, you can refer to ICSI syllabus. It is the paper 2 of foundation program. So it is called Business Management Ethics and Entrepreneurship. So it also contains the basics of business management. Okay. Then apart from this, you can refer to textbook by CB Gupta on organization behavior. Now, studying organization behavior book is important because topics like leadership, topics like motivation, okay, topics like perception, attitude, personality, these types of topics are not covered in the general management book. Okay, so you have to refer to the organization behavior textbook. Okay, you can refer to the graduation level book by CB Gupta, Dr. CB Gupta. So you will get the leadership theories, motivation theories, which are very, very important from the exam point of view. Then apart from that, for human resource management or HRM, you can refer to book by T.N. Chhabra or you can refer to book by Ashwathapa. So one of them, okay, either book by T.N. Chhabra or book by Ashwathapa. So this human resource management book will contain topics such as recruitment, selection, training and development, okay, remuneration. Then you have topics like morale, employee welfare. So all these topics will be covered in the human resource management book. Okay. So basically three books you have to refer: management book, HRM book, and OB book. Okay. Organization behavior. And apart from that, on the ICMAI portal, you can refer to the study material of paper 1 in the foundation course. It is regarding fundamentals of economics and management. Okay. Now after that, the next subject is finance. Okay, so in finance, what you have to study: financial system, roles and functions of regulatory bodies, financial markets like primary and secondary markets, then other topics like derivatives, financial inclusion, alternate source of finance, direct and indirect taxes, and inflation. So these are some of the topics you have to study in finance. So in finance, some of the topics you will get in the textbook, but other topics such as financial inclusion, private and social cost benefit, public private partnership, okay, so these types of topics you would not generally get in the textbook, so you have to Google them and study them on your own. Okay, now so in finance you can refer to ICAI website, paper 8, financial management and economics for finance. Okay, so this particular paper or this particular study material contains topics relating to forex. Okay, it contains topics relating to forex, it contains topics relating to money supply. Okay, so this particular paper 8, it is also beneficial for your preparation of economics. So this will also help you in your preparation for economics subject. Okay, so this economics for finance is basically contains topics relating to macroeconomics. Okay, and apart from that, it contains topics like fiscal policy, which is part of your finance. Then paper 6B of final course is regarding financial services and capital markets. So this will cover a lot of topics like equity market, bond market, derivatives, okay, forex market. Then ICSI paper 6, securities law and capital markets. And paper 7, economic, commercial and business law. So this paper 7, economic, commercial and business law, it contains topics relating to forex, okay, forex market, FEMA Act. Okay, then it contain topics like forex, FEMA, okay, then foreign exchange. So these types of topics are covered in the economic, commercial and business laws. Then ICSI paper 7, corporate funding and listing in stock exchange. So this contains the sources of funding for companies. So basically the topic of alternate sources of finance, the topic of alternate sources of finance is covered in a great extent by this paper 7, corporate funding and listing in stock exchanges. Now, apart from this, you have a topic of GST also, okay, in the finance syllabus. So for GST, you can either Google them, the topic of GST, or you can refer to the study material of ICSI, paper 2, Advanced Tax Laws, or you can refer to paper 8 of the ICAI final course, Indirect Tax Laws, or paper 4 of intermediate course, Taxation. So these all these material, they also contain information regarding GST, but they contain GST information in detail. So you don't have to study GST in so much detail. You have to only study the basics of GST. Okay, so don't go into too much depth. That is not required. Now, apart from that, you can refer to the Business Studies textbook part 2. You can refer to part 2 of BST textbook. You can either refer to the NCRT or you can refer to some other author. So this also contains information about financial markets. So if you want to study the basics about financial markets, then you can first study the BST book and then you can go to other study material. And apart from that, there is a book by Bharti Pathak called Indian Financial System. This is a really good book, as I have personally read this book. So I recommend you to go through this book. This will cover a lot of topics of your finance. Okay. Now, after that, next subject is costing. So in costing, the syllabus is overview of cost and management accounting, methods of costing, cost control and analysis, standard costing, marginal costing, budgets, and lean system. And there are various methods like JIT, Kaizen, 5S, TPM. Okay. So let us discuss the books for this. So you can refer to the paper 3 of intermediate course, which is cost and management accounting. So this will cover the basics of costing and management. So if you look at the syllabus, your first 3 points, point 1, point 2 and point 3, these will be covered by the study material which I am going to tell you. But the fourth point, which is lean system and innovation, this you have to study on your own through Google, because these topics are generally not available in the textbook. Okay. Then next is ICSI Executive Program Paper 2, Cost and Management Accounting. This is also a very good study material. I have gone through this PDF. And then ICMI Intermediate Course Paper 8, Cost Accounting, and Paper 10, Cost and Management Accounting. So this is regarding costing. And apart from that, you can cover, go through the cost accounting textbook. These are graduation level textbooks for cost accounting by M.N. Arora or by M.L. Agarwal. So either of these two books you can go through to study cost accounting. Okay. So either you can go through these books or you can refer the study material by ICMAI, ICSI. Okay. You can either refer to that material or you can refer to these books. Okay. The next subject is Companies Act. So in Companies Act, you have been given specific chapters on which you have to focus. So chapter 3, 4, 8, 10, 11, 12 and 27. So for Companies Act, you can refer to paper 4 of final course of ICAI, Corporate and Economic Laws. Okay. Or you can refer to the study material of ICSI, paper 2, Company Law. Or you can refer to paper 2 of intermediate course, Corporate and Other Laws. So these study material contain information about the Companies Act. Okay. But you can also refer to the e-book by Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So on the MCA website, there is an e-book available for Companies Act. So you can refer to that e-book. Why? Because that e-book is updated regularly. So it contains all the recent amendments. So that is why you should always have this e-book handy. This is very, very important because it contains all the recent amendments. Okay. But one drawback of e-book is that it is a bare act, okay, and the language is a bit difficult to comprehend sometimes, okay, and it is also sometimes boring because the content is given section wise. Whereas if you look at the study material above, the topics are given topic wise, or the study material is given topic wise, whereas in the MCA website, it is a bare act which contains information section wise, okay. And apart from that, you can refer to Bayer Act by Taxman. If you want to read the Bayer Act, you can also refer to the Taxman publication Companies Act. Or you can refer to Company Law book by Professor Anil Kumar. So this is a graduation level book, and the benefit of this book is that it contains the information topic wise. So it will not be very boring to read. Okay. Then after that, the last subject is economics. So in economics, you have microeconomics also and macroeconomics also. So in microeconomics, you have topics like demand and supply, market structure. Whereas in macro, you have topics like national income, BOP, okay, classical and Keynesian approach. So there are various other topics. So let us see from where you can study these topics. So first of all, for clearing your basics, you can refer to the class 12th textbook. So there are two books. One is microeconomics and one is macroeconomics. So you can refer to the NCERT textbooks. Okay. Or you can refer to books by Sandeep Garg. Sandeep Garg is an author for class 12th economics. Okay. So you can refer to either NCERT or Sandeep Garg for your conceptual clarity or basic understanding. And after that, you can study from the paper 4 of foundation course, business economics. It also contains the basics of micro. Then intermediate course, paper 8, FM and economics for finance. Okay. So this contains topics related to Forex and topics related to macroeconomics like national income. Okay. Then ICSI study material foundation program, paper 3, business economics. Then you can refer to paper 7 of ICSI executive program, which is economic, business and commercial laws. Okay. So this contains various laws such as FEMA and contains information regarding Forex market. Okay. Then you have ICMAI foundation course paper 1, which is fundamentals of economics and management. So this is this contains the basics of economics. Then apart from that, you can also refer to graduation level books, BCom level books for micro and macro by Professor H.L. Ahuja. Okay. So H.L. Ahuja is the author of micro and macroeconomics for BCom level. So these two textbooks are also really good. So you can refer to these books for higher understanding. So for basic understanding, you can refer to the class 12th textbook. But for higher understanding, you can refer to these books by H.L. Ahuja, or you can refer to the study material which I discussed in the previous slide. So friends, I hope you must have liked this video, because मैंने इस वीडियो में बहुत ही डिटेल में आपको बताया है कि आप कौन से सोर्सेज से अपने पेपर 2 की तैयारी कर सकते हैं. तो अगर आप खुद तैयारी करना चाहते हैं, सेल्फ प्रिपरेशन करना चाहते हैं, तो आप मेरे बताए गए सोर्सेज से पढ़ाई कर सकते हैं. सो इफ यू हैव लाइक दिस वीडियो, then please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. Prepare hard for the examination. Have a nice day.